regrets. I was certain my love was still alive. I heard the colors of his voice on the radio. I swear.
Maybe I'm mistaken, I'm a little shaken by that beautiful, colorful voice of yours. The patterns and the repetition, you tell me I won't listen. You're all alone, you're telling me, it's all a joke she's telling me. Like in this hard game of telephone, these are the girls of my world. Like a misspelled word I'll never use. It's there in black and white, it's all freshly typed. Sorry, but things have changed. You're not the girl I used to know. It's killing me. And in the depths of my memories, your stories echo from the past, because your fears caught up with you at last. Sorry, I really am. My final words are on the page in black and white, and on the hallway of memories, your vibrant eyes emit a glow that drains my heart of love.
Thinking, Henry quit his job as a journalist. That night, he packed his necessary belongings and made attempts to escape the house without catching Nancy's attention. Quietly, he made his way out of bed, down the hall, through the kitchen. His hand was hovering above the doorknob when the kitchen lights flickered on. Nancy had been startled awake by the absence of a body lying next to her. Henry, suitcase in hand, made it quite clear of exactly what he was planning to do. Overcome with emotion and unstable in her reasoning, Nancy pulled a knife out of a kitchen drawer.